Although we will soon leave the cave and return to our above-ground homes, many creatures make their homes right here in the cave, all year round, even when the lights are turned out. Springtails make up some of these cave animals. They are tiny, about the size of a piece of dandruff. There are at least 8 species of springtails that live in Lehman Caves, and they are the most abundant invertebrate. If your ancestors lived in the dark for millennia, would they need eyes? Probably not. And the tiny snake range millipede, Nevodesmus ophimontis, doesn't have eyes either. This millipede is very white, as it no longer needs pigment to protect it from the sun. Millipedes are detrivores, eating detritus, like old decaying woods and plants. Flies and beetles also live in the cave, although many of them don't live their entire lives in the cave. Nevertheless, if you look carefully, you can find dead flies along some of the cave walls, and in some places, their bodies have become part of the speleothems. The top invertebrate predator in the cave is the Great Basin Cave pseudoscorpion, Microcriagris grandis. Pseudo means false, and this pseudoscorpion, or false scorpion, does not have a tail stinger like true scorpions. Pseudoscorpions catch their prey with large claws, called pedipalps. They take the prey to their mouth, then regurgitate digestive enzymes from their mouth into the prey's tissues to dissolve their insides into a broth they can slurp up. The pseudoscorpion was first noticed in the cave in 1930, but it wasn't identified until the 1960s, when Dr. William Muchmore found it was a new species to science. It has since been found in other caves in the Snake Range, but nowhere else on Earth, making it an endemic species. Every 3 months, park staff study the cave life by putting out a tiny bit of rancid peanut butter on some flagging tape, and then returning 24 hours later to see what creatures have been attracted to the putrid smell. This biomonitoring effort has been conducted for over a decade and is still ongoing. Caves are often homes to endemic species, as they have specialized habitats. Changes to those habitats can mean that the species that live in them have nowhere else to live. Protecting cave creatures is another good reason to take care of caves.